At Tilenga Oil Fields, Total Energies has already installed two drilling rigs as drilling is projected to kick off. The two rigs, fitted with a mast designed in the side saddle way, have been erected at Jobiri and Njiri oil fields in Nyoya and Balisa district respectively. Within the Tilenga Industrial Area site, preparation works for the construction of the central processing facility is close to completion, with Mark DeMotte as a contractor to build the central processing facility. The facility will clean up the produced crude oil by separating it with the gas, removing the sand, water and other impurities before it is exported from the projected area.
Industrial area site preparation works, that is EI project, they are at 89%. That is Motor Angel with their site preparation works. As you can see, almost everything is in place. And then CPF, 100% of it has already been handed over to EPSCC contractor. That's Mark DeMotte.
Overall project is aimed at, we are aiming at ensuring that by the mid of 2025, these projects are ready, like he mentioned. And he mentioned, he used word very selectively, the first trains of activities and production can actually be handled within the CPF. That does not necessarily mean that the project is completely finished.
Other activities going on is the construction of the support base, which will host the materials and workshops to support the construction of the central processing facility. Construction of the 4,000-man temporary camp is to accommodate the personnel and the operators' support base and operators' camp that will support the future operations of the central processing facility and other Tilenga facilities. Tilenga oil field has over 426 wells, of which 200 are water injector wells, 196 oil producer wells and 2 polymer pilot wells, and 28 reference wells, which are planned to be drilled on 31 well pads. It's expected to produce 190,000 barrels of oil and 700,000 barrels of total liquid per day. Compensation of the 5,523 project-affected persons is near completion, with 135 resettlement houses already handed to the physically displaced project-affected persons out of the 235 required houses.
We had 622 project-affected persons, of which 30 were permanent community members who got 30 houses. And again, maybe one area is the choice of where the house should be built or the houses be built, dependent on them. It was just now Ochowun showing me where the house should be built. Then Total, under the project, acquiring the land, putting up the structure, processing the title, and handing over the house with the title to this project affected person.
Some project affected persons have been put into various livelihood improvement programs by Total Energies, including agriculture, fruit tree farming, beekeeping, livestock, vocational skills and job opportunities.
For compensating them, we took them through financial literacy training, because then some of them were getting big sum of money for the first time, so they needed to know how to use the money. We did that training under Resettlement Action 1, and many of them have made good use of the money.
According to the manager, Corporate Affairs and Public Relations at Petroleum Authority of Uganda, domestic companies have highly participated in the development of the Tilenga industrial area and have won several contracts in regards to construction of staff houses and other supply deals. Over 4,000 workers are currently on site, but they have stepped up demands for skills transfer from the foreign oil participating companies by putting stricter requirements to train local employees for high skills jobs.
So the companies are required to train the Ugandans that they're employed with. Then even on the side of government, as part of knowledge transfer, we have, when we recruit engineers and geologists, they are attached to the projects where the detailed engineering is being done.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.